Heyo, we did
the biggest flex you can do is when you have not one, but two fucking side by side.
Hold on. Wait. Someone just sent me a meme, and it's only gonna matter to like the Fringy and Mahler. But you remember when we were watching Halo, and I said that thing? Someone just sent me this meme.
Oh, I wonder what they would be referencing other than the thing that you. Well, I don't. I can see it. I can see the vibe. It's a weird thing to say, but I can kind of get the. I can see why you'd connect them. I can. Doom is better.
I wonder if. Doom is better. Like, unironically, Doom. Which one? When did that one come out? 2003?
Five.
Doom 2005 with The Rock, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, is better than Halo the TV series.
Oof.
I'm not sure about that. I'm pretty sure about that, honestly.
I am legitimately pretty certain. I will. You know what I'll do? I will take that to the bank.
He's taking it to the bank. Can't stop him.
I will take it to the bank that Doom 2003 is better than Halo the TV series.
There you go.
I'm fucking doing it. Let's go banking.
Now I can't quite remember why I'm playing this context clip before whatever comes next. I'm just gonna replay just in case.
You have not one, but two fucking side-by-side bathrooms, you know what I mean?
No, not really. No, I really don't know what he means by this. I'm not sure if
this person just doesn't like a son. That's just what this is, because
it could be that the sentiment that Hassan had is it's a flex to have two toilets next to each other. Now, I don't know about any of you in chat. I don't really think that's a flex, to be honest.
I mean, I understand what he means by that. Like, this is totally unnecessary and stupid, but I'm gonna do it anyway because it just like costs money.
I feel like there's gotta be a limit on that for flexing.
There has to be some kind of
flex.
Yeah, because
what is the flex?
You don't go to like a rich person's house and they're like, look at all my bathrooms next to each other. It's more like an industrial situation. Like, it's like the opposite of a flex.
If I infused excrement into all my walls in my house, I'd be like, that was really difficult and it was a lot of money to pull that off. How's that for a flex? You'd be like, no, that's not a flex. You're just a fucking moron. However, if you buy like the most expensive car in the world and it's known for breaking down a lot, I'd be like, yeah, I get why. Yeah, you got a lot of money. Yeah. I understand. Yeah, that one makes a lot more sense to me. And it's funny because there's a cultural element here as well. Like, if we had met someone who's in their culture, the more shit you can balance on your head, the cooler you are. If someone walked up to us with that's our culture. To some degree, yeah, you know, wrong. But we would just be like, oh, that's a flex. You're like, yeah. So I don't know. Someone, if I went to someone's house, they're like, hey, check out my bathroom, and I look in, there's two toilets next to each other. Just like, huh? I'd be like, why the fuck do you? and my head immediately goes to like, uh-oh, what is this for? Like, you have a lot of money. The whole you have a lot of money thing doesn't come into it really.
All that's happened here is Jay said, I don't get it. And then our relevance be like, he just hates his son. Man, talk about a leap.
Well, so
like, this is a massive leap.
This is the thing. So conclusion, I know what Hassan wanted to try and get across. I don't think this would be considered a flex. It's kind of just creepy and strange. Like, I don't know why. hence, I think Jay's confusion. Like, how is two toilets a flex? And so...
Maybe it's so that you can poop alongside your beloved.
Yeah.
Some couples say we do everything together, they mean everything together.
Mm. It's just like a mid-joke that Jay was like, what? And that's the interaction. And it's totally fine to say I don't really get someone's joke, but our relevance decided this is evidence that Jay is like big mad.
It makes sense to have two toilets next to each other because... toilets are such a valuable commodity. Fringy, what do you think?
I feel like there was a point being made there, and then we just sort of went back to the toilets again.
That's fine. That's all right. That's fine.
We should move on.
That's fine. It's all right.
If you know when you shit on him for saying two bathrooms instead of two toilets, that you're down bad. Like,
So Hassan, if you heard in the clip, Hassan referred to two toilets as two bathrooms.
Oh,
oh yeah. Right, because you're Americans and you do that.
No, they don't do that. Hassan's talking about the toilet itself, as he called it a bathroom. Yeah.
Because we talked about the, like, you have full baths, half baths, three-fourth baths here.
But in America, you are, say I'm going to the...
That's all irrelevant.
But I just want to clarify the point. When you guys, you say you go to the bathroom, right, when you go to the toilet.
Right.
Yeah, okay, yeah, that's it. I'll just clarify.
Because toilets are generally in bathrooms.
Hassan just had a brain fart and called the toilet itself, the actual item of the toilet, a bathroom.
A bath.
Yeah.
Which is really funny, but yeah, Jay points that out. It's a funny, and then our relevant's like, wow, how could you do that?
It is funny, yes.
And sometimes, I feel like there's like a jump to defensiveness on all sides sometimes, and sometimes you can just realize... sometimes you can just be like, it's chill, I'm just pointing out something funny you said, that's all.
Yeah, it's like, it's fine, it's chill, relax, it's fine. It's, you said bathroom instead of toilet, it's fine. It's just a little funny, it's all good.
Saying two bathrooms instead of two toilets, that you're down bad. Like, just fucking go about your business.
Supposed
to go about your business?
go
about your business reacting to someone's content? That is, what?
He sounds really annoyed that, Jay did it. It's just like, but it's funny, why wouldn't someone highlight that? It's funny.
It is funny that he calls toilets bathrooms. Toilets are inside of bathrooms, typically. They are not the bathroom. You go to the bathroom with the understanding that you will use the facilities in there. You're not going in there to play fucking racquetball. People know what you mean when you say you're going to the bathroom.
Yeah.
I mean, that would be a flex if you had a racquetball court.
Yeah, that would be a flex. Like, would you like to go to my bathroom? Psych! It's a fucking racquetball court.
And
wait, what is racquetball?
It's when a racquetball court is... Do you really not know? You not have a...
I mean, is it a squash court? Is that, or is racquetball different from squash?
Ooh, see, well, I
one's
don't know.
A vegetable, isn't it?
Racquetball is squash. Yeah, it's squash.
Oh, okay. Oh, is it? Are they the same name? Okay, because it's racquetball.
Maybe it's like squash. Maybe
I feel like they're different.
Racquetball versus squash.
Oh,
let me take a look.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because they play racquetball in Angel, and I always thought of it as squash when I saw them play it.
Yeah,
do you play it on the same court? Is that what the confusion is?
Yeah, you're on the same court, and you're on, and you hit it against... Oh, well, maybe...
So squash is racketless? Is sans racket, you might say?
Wait, okay, so people are saying that...
Much like our relevance commentary, it is sans racket.
Nice.
People are saying that there's a difference slightly, that they're kind of similar.
They are very similar, though, yeah.
Because I was about to say something that might be stupid, kind of like how softball and baseball are similar, but not quite the same.
They are very similar, yes.
Yeah, okay, we got rounders over here that's similar to that as well. It's like a very...
It's almost exactly the same.
I think there's slightly different rules or something, but yeah.
I figure there are. The only thing I know about softball is the ball is not soft. It is incredibly hard.
Squash is a gay fruit. Rags is not correct.
No, that is a gourd. A gourd is a gay fruit.
What was it? Oh yeah, it's funny that he said go about your business when we're talking about toilets.
Yeah, go about your business.
And he sounded so serious, like, it's such a good little meme.
Go about your business. Carry on, move along, nothing to see here.
Just fucking go about your business.
Supposed to be a joke, a serious comment, or a mix of the two? Is he trying to say that flex is normally something extravagant and unnecessary, and this is extravagant and unnecessary?
I guess. Yeah. Yeah, it's a bit weird. Why would you pick...
It's weird.
That's not extravagant, though.
It's weird. That's like the first thought everyone has when they see two toilets in a room. Like, why?
It's very strange. It's because normally going to the toilet and using the poo facilities is not a social affair.
You assume straight away that there's purpose to it. Like, did you build
because you cannot accidentally do that, really, because there was a lot of pipe work and interior stuff
that goes into a bathroom. Damn it.
Yeah, like, it's difficult to accidentally build an extra toilet next to another toilet.
If someone
That's hard to do.
if someone walks into your garage and sees like a Ferrari, and then they're like, oh, that's so cool. If someone walks into that toilet,
they probably go, ow!
They're just going to be like confused.
Should I use one of these or either? Is either okay? Or
go
should
back
I
and
just...
forth between the two?
Is there a difference between these two toilets that is essential? Is one a piss one and one a poop one?
See, now that would be a flex. If you had a piss and a poop toilet, that were separate.
And they were labeled
having
as such.
A piss toilet, also known as a urinal.
A urinal?
No, it's a normal toilet.
For piss.
Into the toilet, yes. If someone walks into the toilet, we call the toilet room the toilet. Often
to be fair,
there is a toilet room specifically.
I think that room had a bath in it as well, so we probably call it a bathroom, right?
Did it have a bath in it? I only saw the two. Does it have a bath in it?
It's a really weird room. I think it actually has a urinal in it as well.
It's just a fully featured. It's a fully featured.
Well,
like...
a normal bathroom into like.
That's the thing you could assume about it. But what I would the thing that puts a question in my mind is like, how did it end up with only two toilets and a urinal when you know like. Those rooms typically have a whole set that lists the wall or something, but like, it's fine.
This is a house, though. They're trying to
Did it used to be like a larger facility? Like it used to have stalls there.
Do you think they had cubicles and they removed them?
Yeah, they were. You could say they were uninstalled. So now you just have the two toilets next to each other, because if you went into a toilet room. A bathroom, if you will, with many of them without stalls.
A room of toilets.
It would just be like, this is a really strange room.
No, what probably happened is that this is a normal house and they're trying to repurpose it for this use of multiple people peeing and pooping in the bathroom. And they're not going to like change a normal room and like put all the plumbing in a normal room to make it like a larger normal bathroom facility.
Well, it would make more sense that it was designed with multiple toilets in mind because of all the plumbing and stuff that you have to do to have that bathroom.
Well, but I would imagine
uninstalled or didn't install stalls that were supposed to be there.
Well, would that make sense or would it make...
Yes, like, it makes more sense than what you said.
No. Like if you were you want to add extra toilets to a house... cheaply, wouldn't it make sense? Wouldn't it be cheaper to add them to the bathroom as opposed to creating a whole new room with piping that goes into it?
I actually don't know because
I would say probably
creating a to make a if it was literally only to install another toilet regardless of anything else, I suppose. But that would be a bizarre thing to say, I want another toilet for more people to go to the bathroom simultaneously.
Oh, dude, the builders would have been like, why?
No. See, you're assuming that this house is built with that in mind. I'm assuming the house existed, and then they're just repurposing it.
Well, so
repurposing it into what? That's why my stall idea was as it was, yes. Because if you've seen the whole video, this house is like not a house.
Yeah.
It's like a facility complex.
It's like a whole baptism area.
Yeah. Okay, so it's a church. But isn't it being repurposed to be like one of these Amazon houses or something?
It's like a warehouse filled with all kinds of things they're trying to flip, I think. Like DVDs and boxes.
I mean, obviously
it's
a very shoddy operation here.
Oh, yes.
It is madness. It is absolute madness.
Because now I'm still stuck in the toilet bathroom thing. Is it common in America for the toilet to be in the bathroom? Like you just have one room that has the shower and the toilet and the...
Yeah, that's a full bath as if it has a toilet, a bathroom, and a sink.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes they're kind of like separated.
A half bath
like two sections.
Is going to be just like a toilet and a sink is a half bath.
What about like just a separate room that just has a toilet in it? It is only with the toilet. Is that like
only
common,
a toilet?
That...
Possible. Yeah, I have never seen one, but they could exist, I suppose.
Wait, are you saying no sink, just the toilet?
I was going to say, typically you get a sink in most rooms that have a toilet.
Yeah.
No. Do you have it where like the bathroom has the sink, the bath, the shower, but then you just have a room that has a toilet in it and that's it?
They are almost always the same room.
Do you think that there's like a that follows that it might make more sense to just
it does
have
make a lot of
like
sense
a,
piping
a room.
Wise to have it all
right yeah. Okay,
so wait, do you have rooms that are just like showers and that's it?
You can do that. obviously, but typically in Britain anyway, I don't know about Australia, we have full bathrooms and then also rooms that are just a toilet and a sink.
Well, it's just often here in a house, if you're in like a unit or a flat or something, but if you're in a house, generally you have the bathroom that has the sink, the shower, and the bath, and then you have a toilet that's just the toilet.
But also
it's
a sink,
a room,
right?
That has a toilet in it. No, you go into the bathroom to wash your hands.
Okay,
it's like you open a closet-sized room that's just a toilet, like, and that, and just four walls, and that's it.
And then you have to go to the bathroom to wash your hands.
That's very strange.
That is very strange to me as well.
Does it not make more sense that you cordon off the toilet room from like the place where you actually like have showers and stuff and wash your hands?
No, I don't know what you're doing. I mean, it's like toxic waste when you like.
No,
they're segregated.
Because that seems
I'm hung up on the fact that you.
It's very strange. Yeah.
Why would you have a sink in there?
That seems.
Put a sink in there.
Yeah, you have to wash your ass and you have to walk to another room to wash your hands.
Why would you put a sink in a room that is only the size that you need for a toilet?
Because you can
wash
your
hands. Generally, what you do is you consolidate their spaces together for pretty obvious floor plan reasons.
Right.
But what about just sanitary reasons?
That is sanitary
reasons.
That's
why you
keep
them together. Yeah.
But why you put them together.
How nasty are your shits over in Australia that you have to have like a special bio chemical room
down before you flush? Okay?
Yeah, that's the way you do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, sure. I guess I'm just saying, it's just like, feels weird to me that someone might want to take a shower and then there's some other person poofing in there.
No, whoa. No one does that.
That's what happens in comedy movies.
In the shower, you don't just walk in and poof next to them.
I guess I'm just saying.
Nobody does that. That's like a joke.
That's in comedy movies, yeah.
Yeah.
So what I'm saying,
I guess you'd have to be like a very close married couple who are super cash about that sort of thing.
And you don't have stinky shits.
Yeah.
So that's the point I'm making. If someone's there having a shower and you want to go poop, it's way more convenient if there's just a separate poop room so that you could go.
That is the poop closet.
You can leave them to. That
is technically true. However, the amount of times where that will pop up is so minuscule compared to normal time. That it's not
very
worth
unlikely.
Getting rid of all that floor space.
Yeah, that's additional piping that's got to go into another room.
How big are these poop closets? Are they like tiny or is it like a normal room?
Yeah, because floor space is like precious. It's a precious commodity. You can't just make it because there's a lot of
like
regulations
in terms of the space around
the building and the property lines.
Typically, the toilet room is not like several feet away. It's like next to the bathroom. Mm-hmm. It's like the room next to it. So if you're walking down the hallway.
Yeah, but how big is the room itself?
Oh, it's big enough to fit a toilet and you, and then a little bit of space in front of you, and that's it. It's like a narrow room that is just. It's kind of like a cubicle, but it's a room.
They always have sinks in Britain, and oftentimes they're not on the same floor. Like the idea is that you have a toilet on both floors. Yeah, but there won't be two bathrooms. It'd be a bathroom and a toilet.
Oh, well, I mean, typically you'll find here that there'll be like an ensuite, right? So in the master bedroom will have its own separate shower and that.
Yeah,
you can get them here as well.
Really
yeah.
Called, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But like,
is it more normal that the toilet's separated or is it more normal that they're all together?
Well, so
in
Britain, you get the toilet is always in the bathroom too.
I meant in Australia.
Yeah.
Well, so typically here, if you live in like a flat or something, they'll usually be combined into one because there's not enough space. But in like a house, there'll just be a bathroom and then a toilet.
That's so weird.
And there's no toilet in the bathroom.
The bathroom is in an ensuite, maybe, or in like a flat, you'll find it where it's got the bathroom and the shower and the bath and then the sink. But then you'll just have it be that there's the room that has the bath, the shower, and the sink, and then there's a room that just has a toilet in it.
So I can't go straight from pooping to a shower?
Well, you can. You just go into the bathroom, then wash your hands, then take a shower.
Yeah, but so what if someone's in the shower and you're pooping, and then you're done? How are you have to get in to wash your hands anyway?
Sure, but I mean, they might be finished by then, right?
That applies to the other scenario.
That applies to, yeah.
I guess.
How does it apply to the other scenario?
They might be finished by the time you need to get in there.
You save a precious 5 to 10 poops minutes. Okay, that's what we're doing here.
Fucking, look, I'm
fine
with...
And also, generally, it's... It most people will say, "Hey, I'm going to take a shower. If you need to use the loo, I'll be 10 minutes."
They do that, yeah.
Yes, but which is what normal people do. It's like, "Aha, I don't need to wait because there is a separate room."
Oh, you will when you need to wash your hands.
You got to wait to wash your hands, though.
Yeah, you can't wash your hands.
Sure, but only. I'm just saying that it just increases the chat. It is more likely that you will be able to wash your hands because they are finished than it is in the other scenario where you cannot poop. That you cannot deny that logic.
I can,
there's
and I will.
There's gotta be some weird reason for this.
You cannot deny that logic.
I just did. Watch me do it again. I deny your logic.
Is there any other, like, country or culture that separates their toilets like this?
I don't know. Backwards society like China or something.
So the reason why you cannot deny it is a simple equation. Let's say that it is 10 a.m. and there is someone in the shower and you need to take a poop. If they are in, if the bathroom is the room that also has the toilet in it, you just can't because of like you're stuck. There's nothing you can do. You cannot commence the poop. You just have to wait until they're done and then you can go in.
Well, so unless you have diarrhea, what's the problem?
But if you have a separate poop room, you could just go take a poop straight away. And then there is a chance that you will be able to get in there because they'll be finished and wash your hands.
Why would anyone risk this instead of waiting?
Is there like an epidemic of explosive diarrhea in Australia that has caused this architectural
shift? I don't know why it can't just be that someone's like, I want to go now. I just need to go now. I'd like to go
because
now.
Because like, it's not generally that big of a deal because my body doesn't go, I don't go from just normal living to, oh my God, you have to take a shit
unless something's wrong.
It's generally not that, but you could just be sitting there playing video games and go, you know what? I need to poo. And then you just get up and
you're
like,
someone's in the shower. So you're like, well, I guess I'll wait an extra few minutes.
I'll come back and just
or alternatively, I could commence my poop and hopefully they'll be finished by then.
Or you can put a sink in your toilet.
You could put a sink in your toilet. I feel like you don't understand the size of this room. The room is small.
Great, we have them in Britain.
A room that has a toilet and a sink and no bath or shower.
All right. Yeah, that's
chat, common. Help me out here. Small, little cubicle rooms in Britain. I assume there's at least one person who's British. And it has a sink in it, too. I'm going to have to get pictures for you.
Like, if you have a house in America, there'll often be, like, a bathroom that has a toilet and a shower and a bath. And then there'll be just a room that's just a toilet and a sink.
And that's a half bath, yes. Yeah, that's why, like, on all the real estate everything, that's why you full bath, half bath.
A half bath.
Yep, half bath.
Let me see.
Oh, there you go. Beautiful example.
You also have a 3/4 bath, but those are a lot less common.
What? Oh, I see those when like you go out to a restaurant or something where they'll have like just the one bathroom that has like the.
Yeah. I tend to only go to restaurants that have baths in them, so then after the meal I can enjoy a nice
a nice shower after your bath.
Nice shower and bath after you know.
You sit, like typically, yeah, no, I've definitely seen those.
I've seen those. Yeah, but I just think this is
I've
very normal to me.
I
just wouldn't have thought you'd want to build a room with a toilet with no sink when they seem inseparable to me because. You know,
I've but never seen just a toilet in a room. I've never seen like, that in my life.
You could just go to the bathroom and wash your hands. That's true.
I have literally seen more holes in the ground to poop in than a room in a building with just a toilet.
Well, again, that's apparently just America doesn't do that. But
yeah, we just don't do that.
I just
because if we're doing it, we're doing at least a half bath.
I will say, by the way, I am baffled by the disdain in chat. You still go and wash your hands in the bathroom just
it
because
it seems
the
so inefficient
not
in compared.
You wash your hands.
Yeah, but you also have to open the door, though, first.
Yeah, you get to throw your poopy hands. Ugh, that's nasty. Ugh.
If you're going into the bathroom to poop, you're always going to wash your hands
anyway.
Whoa,
that's before you
think about it. You have to go into...
transversal through walls. You can't skip that.
You have to go to your separate bathroom. You close the door. You shit. You wipe your ass. Then you have to open your door before you wipe...
Presumably, you were doing it efficiently enough that your hand is not covered in poo. I would hope...
Well, then
that's not the best... You're making an argument against washing your hands in general.
No, you still wash your hands.
Pro germs.
The whole idea is you knock off any residual jibs of any kind.
Fringy loves goo and poo.
Yeah, because you're right. You got to open and close the toilet door, then open and close the bathroom door. So why do all of that instead of just washing your hands in the toilet?
Here, I will pick up my phone. I will text my architect parents and ask if they have ever designed or even seen a toilet in a box. Let's just call it that.
But like Rags, surely you understand though. Even if you were to do it, you wouldn't make it without the sink, right?
Of course, because when you're bathrooms are a special thing. Really, any place where you have to hook up water through the wall is something you have to really think about when you're designing a building in relationship to the pipes going to other buildings and how the pipes intersect with themselves and where they meet. It's a special thing. So if you're going to have a toilet, you're like, yeah, we're going to put a sink there with it because we've already gone through all the trouble of designing this room with water pipes in them.
Mm-hmm.
I think if Dev arrives in any minute now, it'll be so funny if he says what I miss.
Yeah, I'm texting my pot hair right now.
Well, supposedly, I was trying to see if there's a reason for this. Supposedly, Australian toilets on average work differently than American toilets. They have, like, larger holes at the bottom, and they're jet-powered, as opposed to just
a normal little flush.
Is this true for me?
Why don't Australians wash their hands after that?
Let me Google that.
Maybe they just blame the wildlife for all of them dropping dead when it's really just like horrible, just terrible poo diseases. Like, oh no, it was the giant spider. Yeah, it killed Jim. He didn't waste away from the horrific infection from his poo door. No.
Oh my god. So apparently their toilets don't require plumbing because of the nature of the way they're built, and thus there was difficulty in providing a sink additionally.
Wait,
what? I don't understand.
That's what it said. So I'll just read this out. Why is it common for Australian houses to have a toilet in a small cubicle without a sink? And apparently the best answer is, I've seen houses in both England and Canada with this setup. I've never seen it in the US. The one in England had a toilet, no sink, in a separate room next to the room with the sink and the tub. Each room had its own door. Where's the Australian answer?
Oh, the picture that you just posted. Is the tank at the very top? Is that what that thing is up there? That's the tank?
That's an older design for a toilet, but you're right, yeah.
Because I've never seen one of those before.
I don't know
what to tell you guys, because now I've just gone onto realestate.com and looked at a bunch of houses' floor plans just to remind myself that I'm not crazy, and I'm not.
Oh, we didn't say we didn't believe you. We're saying it's stupid design.
Yeah.
Okay, you can say it's a stupid design, but chat has been very mean to me, and it's led me to the point where I'm sitting here, and I'm genuinely wondering if, like, I've gone insane and I'm sure it's true.
Gaslighting Fringy.
It is common. It is. Yeah, I pulled up another one.
Yeah,
yep,
it is common
it is.
In
I pulled up
upside
another
down
one.
World,
there
yeah.
it is. There are many, many bathrooms that are just their own cordoned off separate rooms. Looking on these floor
this
plans
is what happens
many, many,
when
many
you
many
live
houses.
When a civilization's built that can't see Polaris. It's just everything's upside down. Nothing
oh,
makes sense. It's all just it. Ugh.
God, dude, someone's explanation.
I feel sane now. I'm serious. I was there sitting there like, am I going nuts? Am I like
I mean,
in
just,
a bizarro world?
Just
where
learning
makes sense?
That the rest of your countrymen are insane shouldn't
dude,
make
Sitch,
you feel more.
Well,
sane.
It gets better. One of the explanations here is that when you did outhouse pooping, hand washing wasn't a big deal back then, and so it didn't pass over when they moved the toilet into the house.
That can't be real. No.
I love that they try to explain to me, like, well, you know,
when Australians were tribal.
Yeah, Australians just didn't figure out that you should wash your hands. What?
This is what happens when a bunch of prisoners make a nation.
Don't this toilet room need a sink? Why?
Why? When you just go wash your hands?
There's water in the toilet. I don't understand. Why you need another toilet?
There's water in the toilet.
Well, that was another thing I was worried about. When I say wash your hands in the toilet, I was hoping people didn't think I meant.
Just dunk your hands in there.
That's why you flush it. It's clean water now, right?
Exactly. Australian toilets have dual purpose. Okay?
Yes.
That's why we got that little pink thing on the rim to clean it, right?
Water is scarce in the deserts of Australia, okay? We just don't understand.
Mate, do you use salt water for your toilet?
Why would we use salt water for the toilet?
I don't know, because you're an island.
You
I don't know.
Because you guys do things weird, I don't know.
I don't know. What you do in that upside-down, topsy-turvy world.
You guys want to continue with the video? We can do that.
I
don't like this conversation.
Fleam cringe. Speaking of fleam cringe.
Let's go back to some proper fleam cringe.
Supposed to be a joke, a serious comment, or a mix of the two? Is he trying to say that a flex is normally something extravagant and unnecessary, and this is extravagant and...
Yeah, because you could see here there's clearly enough room for a stall.
Yeah, I think
to
you're
go
right.
through those two, yeah. There are technically a lot of specifications and regulations for
you started this conversation, Fringy. So is that how it works? When someone starts a conversation, you have carte blanche to be incredibly cruel to them? Is that how it works?
Incredibly cruel.
Incredibly cruel.
I'm sure they're saying out of love, Fringy.
Not only that, but only one of the people has access to all the toilet paper, because notice how much right. notice how much toilet the toilet paper king over here on the right. He has all the toilet paper, and there's not even a roll in between the two toilets.
He has
an empty roll
on the thing. He
has to leverage his position of strength by having both the plungers on the left, and he used that to bargain for toilet paper.
And he
also has
the
two waste baskets.
Yeah, why are there two trash cans, and one's like teeny tiny and one's normal size?
Because the left toilet realized it doesn't have any bargaining power in terms of toilet paper, so it needed to grab both the plungers and the waste baskets. It's a trade deal.
I'll give you one of my bins
for this. Give you a trash can. Give me some toilet paper.
Yeah, in exchange for ongoing usage of X amount of squares per poo, I will allow you to use the waste basket. Assuming that you don't want to flush your toilet paper down, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
it also makes sense, too, that this was a room where they removed the stalls.
Yeah.
Because on the right, they have the rail. Though it's odd, because normally the handicapped stall is going to be the last one in the back.
This room is too small, I think, to have two.
I don't think this room's up to code. I don't think it's up to code.
And by the way, Jay got it, okay?
No, I know what it is!
You understood.
Okay. That where the second toilet is, that used to be where the sink was.
They converted the sink into another toilet.
Hey, a bunch of Australians moved in, and they're like, why is there a sink in my toilet room?
They were like, but what about the sink? And then they just put down a bin. You're like...
No. Just to spite people in Europe and America, instead of saying we're going to install a sink, they said, fuck it, we're installing another toilet. Just to show them that we mean business.
A nice use of the word business once again.
Wait, what? J-Mac has a separate bathroom? For his toilet? What craziness is this?
Wait, where's J-Mac from?
He's American. That's probably attached to his bathroom, though. It's like a little cubby just for
like,
the toilet.
I've never seen one, ever. I've never seen one.
Yeah, I've never seen one so extravagant.
To illustrate
how short is this guy that he needs steps to get up to his toilet? No,
it's a squatty potty. You don't know about the squatty potty? Come on.
I don't know about a squatty potty.
you put your legs on it, and it's supposed to make you squat when you shit and help your digestive process.
If it's in California, it doesn't count. they do weird things over there.
That's true. Is California the Australia of America?
At least the toilets, maybe.
We don't talk about California.
My wife likes it.
Do you live in a hotel where your doors have that little, like the lever handle? That's strange.
It does have that lever. Some places have them, right? Some houses. Usually,
generally, they'll be in like hotels and things. That's strange to have a. It's fine. It's just it's very. Odd, it's not something you normally see in a private residence.
I always find it weird when they have the little fluffy covers for toilets. Yeah.
Oh, the carpet. Yeah, that was a thing.
Yeah.
For all of you youngins out there, it's like wood paneling on the outside of cars. Mm-hmm. There was a thing where your toilet seat would be carpet. Lid was
just
carpeted.
It was like extra work for something that provides zero utility. I guess it just makes it comfortable if you feel like using your toilet as a just a seat.
I think that was the idea, down. Right? It's like it's more comfortable to sit on. It's like, yeah,
no, again. I think just to like visually look at.
Well, no, I think it's that too, because they would add like, there was all kinds of different ones that would be softer as well to sit on, but it's just like, you just, not many people, I've sat on a toilet not to poop before, but it just doesn't happen very often, if ever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it just,
That is the 70s. They wanted to cover everything with a weird fur and shag.
Yeah, have you guys seen Barbarella?
I feel like I might have, but I'm going to say no.
It's from 1968. She had her spaceship, the inside of her spaceship. It was all furry.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. That is a film.
Wait, so is that right bathroom there. Off of a bath? That toilet's off a bathroom?
Yeah, I'm assuming, like, so you have the master bedroom. Yes.
Yeah, because that's what I mean. That makes more sense if it doesn't have a sink. That makes more sense if it's attached to a bathroom.
Yes, it is attached to the master bath, which is like a very big bath.
So the complaint that you made was that you put your hand on the handle before you washed your hands. Mm-hmm. The same applies here. You said that's cool, but you said...
Nope.
You said that makes more sense.
No. So if this is a bathroom, then you open the door to the toilet room and you leave the door open because you're in the bathroom, which is closed.
Yeah. Except also, you don't have to turn this handle.
Why would you close the door?
Because you close the door when you poo.
You don't understand. If it's off the bathroom, which is closed, then you don't need to close the toilet door. It's like a cubicle that you leave the door open at that point.
Why does the door exist in your... Why do you think it exists?
Because once you're done, you can close it.
I mean, it's just it's just a small benefit of keeping the smell in there if there is one.
Or I mean, as you said, maybe
like
if
you have a room,
if the wife needs to use
but there's
bathroom.
No sink at that point.
There is a sink in the bathroom that is next to the toilet.
You got to open set of two doors at least to do that. We've already been over this.
The bathroom door is open.
No, you keep in your scenario. You keep closing it. Stop closing
it. The door open exists whether you want to use it or not.
Yeah.
Well, so the problem is that in the picture of this bathroom, if you leave just the toilet door open, you can still close the outer bathroom door.
I've said that like three times. Why am I not being listened to?
I think it's being clear that this is legitimately the most scatological oriented EFAP that we've ever done.
In the Australian scenario, if you leave your door open, you've left your door open to the entire house.
Yeah, this is off the bathroom. That's different.
Yes. It's off the master bath.
Excellent. Anyway, back to the
video. Right.
Is wrong on this one. I think
clean cringe.
Whether right or wrong, that is the nature of bathrooms and toilets in many houses.
We've acknowledged that. We believe you. It's weird as fuck. Put a sink in your toilet.
Yes,
God damn it.
Strange. It is very bizarre. So let's carry on with clean cringe.
Oh, well, what I wanted to say was that there was no vindictive thing here. Like, Jay knew exactly what Hassan was doing. He just said it didn't work. It was a very good joke.
Right.
That's it. But he's just like, why so bad?
Necessary.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a bit weird. Why would you pay for a second toilet installation?